You do not ask a lady for her age. Hi and very welcome. My name is Mary. This is my channel Lumi Level Up and I'm a luxury lover on an average income trying to be more mindful with my money. This is a video about a very special bag in my collection, the classic Louis Vuitton Sac Noué in monogram canvas. It is the grand big size with the leather bottom. And you read it right in the thumbnail, this bag is as old as I am. How do I know? Well, the ones who are deeper into Louis Vuitton for sure know that the bags came with a data code that tells you the year of production. This year, unfortunately, Louis Vuitton switched from putting a data code to put microchips that are not visible from the outside anymore. And I got a little conspiracy video about that topic as well. It's one of my very early videos, but if you're interested, I will put it down in the description box for you. Knowing the year when a bag has been made, therefore, might be way more tricky in the future. But back to the bag, the vintage Louis Vuitton Sac Noué. I want to chit-chat with you about how I got it, how long it has been in my collection, the wear and tear, and if I would recommend to get this bag. Sadly, I do not remember the exact year when I got this bag, but it has been for sure one of my very early Louis Vuitton bags. Maybe number 3. The first one has been my monogram Speedy in the size 35 and the second one a Neverfull MM in Damier Azur. I remember these so well because I bought both of them brand new from store and they have been around only 500 euro back then. But I was still a college student working as a waitress, so it was a lot of money for me and I will forever remember spending it. But back to this beautiful vintage Noël. I bought it from my mom's best friend. And that woman is really a special person. She is about 20 years older than my mom is, so around the age of my grandma. But she is the best example for you are only as old as you feel. And she stayed so young at heart. She had a very exciting life. She has been working as a prima ballerina for the state opera. She was married twice, tragically lost her first husband very early, then was married to a millionaire and got divorced. Well, there was going on a lot in her life, but she is really humble and kind at heart. One day she decided that she wanted to get rid of some of her stuff she didn't use anymore. And one of these items has been the Noué. If I remember it correctly, she even wanted to gift this bag to me, since it was not at all about the money for her and she knew how much I was in love with the brand. But it just didn't feel right for me to get such an expensive gift for free. So we agreed on the incredible price of 200 euro, that's about $240. And I know that has been an extremely low price as well, but it has been nearly about 10 years ago when the prices of the canvas pieces have still been somewhat lower. And at that point in time, the bag has already been quite some years old. But still, of course, I know it was really a very good price for me to pay. And in general, it has been more of a symbolic price to pay, so I don't feel bad for getting this one for free. The actual age of that bag. I was not kidding when I said in the intro, don't ask a lady for her age. But let's agree on the human body decreases once you reach the age of 25. And I'm a good chunk over that point. So this bag for sure is 25 plus 30 plus years old. And isn't it amazing how well it held up? When I got it from my mom's friend nearly 10 years ago, it was in perfect condition. No stain, no nothing. Back then, even the bottom, that is the weak point of this bag, has been in pristine condition. When I got it, it just had some beautiful honey beige patina on the leather parts, since it had already been around 20 years old when I got it. But I guess it hardly has been used by my mom's friend at all. When I got it, I was using it a lot. It gave me more of a casual vibe than my Speedy did. And with the shoulder strap, it's hands-free, but that bag in the Sac Noé Grande version is not so much carefree, because you got a lot of vachetta leather going on, and especially the vachetta leather bottom. And no feet. I got caught by surprise in the rain over the years, so there are some watermarks on the leather parts. The leather on the strap and on the band is really dry by now, and it starts to get slight cracks. I should really condition the bag, but since Louis Vuitton themselves promote to put nothing on the leather and not treat it in any kind of shape, I've always been too scared to do so. The inside is brown fabric lining. There is a little bit of dust, but no stains, and it held up very well. The hardware oxidated somewhat. I'm quite sure there's a way to clean that up, to get it brighter and more shiny again, but to be honest, it never bothered me. So therefore, I never did anything to it as well. The canvas itself is still in perfect condition. We hear this quite a lot, that the quality of Louis Vuitton has decreased over the years and that the canvas on the vintage pieces is of much higher quality. So there is no cracking at all, even though the shape of the bag is quite curved and bent in places and has not so much structure. So it could cause stress to the material, but there are no issues at all. But let's get to the most exciting part, the corners and especially the bottom. Yes, the leather at the corners is scuffed in places, and yes, the bottom does show quite some signs of use. It got some slight stains, it got scratches, and it got marks. And it's just used overall. But there's not that one particular flaw that makes it look nasty and dirty, at least in my eyes. And when you compare my bag with some of the bags that are offered pre-loved, I think mine is still in very good condition, especially considering the age. There are way younger Noés that are way more beaten up. And I didn't baby that bag whatsoever. Not at all. I didn't use it too much lately, since I have quite a bigger handbag collection now to rotate when I feel like monogram canvas. And I try to check the weather very carefully by now when I do wear a bag with vachetta leather. I only wear them now when I should be quite risk-free that there might be any rain at all. But you better believe me, this bag has been through a lot throughout the years. I even have a little horror story to share. A few years ago, I had this bag with me when we went out to have sushi. I think I've been on a shopping trip, and after a while, we went to have lunch. It was very spontaneous, so we didn't have a reservation. It wasn't the most fanciest restaurant. It was a small running sushi place, and it was super crowded. Guess they even had some kind of special lunch offer, which made it even more crowded. So we got a seat, but of course there has not been enough space to get an extra chair for my bag. And the chairs we got have been more of a stool without a back, so I could not even have hung the bag over my chair. And of course it's very uncomfortable to have it over your shoulder all the time. I don't remember exactly if I was even hesitating to put my bag on the floor. Guess I should have, but the only thing I just remember very vividly is how I picked the bag up again after we finished lunch, and there was a huge greasy fat stain about this size. Of course, it was totally my own fault. I put the bag on the floor. Seems like I did not even check beforehand if the floor was clean. Of course, I felt terrible. The shopping trip was ruined. I wanted to go home immediately and try to clean my bag and rescue it. And as you can see, actually, I managed to get rid of that stain. Of course, the bottom is not perfect anymore, but there is not this one big fat stain. To be honest, I do not even remember for sure how I did it, and I'm really surprised it even worked out and did not totally damage the bag. This is no advice at all. If you got a stain on your Louis Vuitton vachetta leather, maybe go see an expert, because I don't want to be accountable if anything goes wrong. If I remember correctly, what I did was use tons of liquid soap, or maybe even shampoo, rubbing it gently onto the stain and dabbing around it with water until there was no soap left. But I did not just dab the stain, but the whole bottom. Because if I would have only treated the stain, then I would get a watermark on the corners where it has been wet. So I worked around the whole bottom. I think I even used a blow dryer to dry the leather quick and evenly. And surprisingly, somehow it did work. Seriously, I can hardly believe I got rid of that greasy, huge fat stain. We have some stains and marks and all that stuff going on here, but it's impossible to tell where the fat stain has been. And all the soap and stuff, it seems like it did not damage the leather. It's not hard and dry at all. Very smooth and soft. So, I guess these were all the stories I have to tell about my birthday bag Louis Vuitton, which is as old as I am. My beautiful vintage lady, the Sac Noé. Honestly, for a 30 plus year old bag, I think it's in amazing condition. And I think this really speaks for the quality of Louis Vuitton. Overall, it held up so well for the way I treated it. And all the little flaws it got over time add to her character and are my own faults. So I kinda even can appreciate them, because it's what I did to her. It connects us. And the bag did nothing wrong at all. I absolutely love mine, but would I recommend getting one? Well, there are pros and cons. The Noé is a Louis Vuitton classic. It has been one of the very early designs of Louis Vuitton and is even claimed to have been the very first handbag of the brand. Not a travel bag or a trunk, created in 1932. Initially made to carry 5 bottles of champagne. After all these years, you can still buy this bag directly from Louis Vuitton. I think that's a huge pro for this bag. If you love the brand, this bag is a piece of the history and heritage. As of today, it is at 1,240 euro and $1,730 in the classic Grand version, available in monogram and damier azur. And it drops in variations in limited editions as well. Not sure if there might have been a Damier Eben version for a limited little time, because that one would solve the problem of the vachetta leather bottom and quite some of the problems with this bag. But for the original, very first version, the leather bottom is really delicate. Even if you never put your bag on the floor, like me stupidly at a running sushi restaurant, it still can pick up marks and stains really quickly. With the size and this boxy shape the bag is, when wearing it really is easy to bump into things and to scuff the corners. It happened to me without even ever realizing. I personally wouldn't get the classic Noé brand new from store, because so much of the light vachetta leather would stress me out so much and give me anxiety. A few years ago, Louis Vuitton came up with a new interpretation of this bag, the Neo Noé, which doesn't have the vachetta leather bottom, and some more slight iterations. If I would go for a brand new one, I most probably would go for the Neo Noé. And spoiler alert, I have one from a limited edition in my collection. Maybe we can make a little comparison between the two, the vintage version, the classic, and the Neo Noé, in a separate video. So if that's something you're interested in and that you don't want to miss, make sure to subscribe. Would I get a classic Sac Noé vintage pre-loved still today? Yes and no. If I came across a good deal, no deal will ever be as good as mine, I guess. I totally would, because it's a great bag. It's a part of Louis Vuitton history, and I really appreciate that. But what I have seen on the pre-loved market so far, the ones that are in good condition, or even very good condition, are quite expensive. Oftentimes only a few hundred less than brand new. In this case, I always wonder if paying just a little bit more and getting a brand new bag with the whole experience, isn't it worth it? And for the ones with the good prices on the pre-loved market, they usually have their flaws. Most of the times, quite visible ones, and most of the times at the bottom. For me, of course, this bag gets some of its character from use, and I can appreciate the flaws mine has, because I gave it to her. And as I already said, I think that kind of connects us. But I personally wouldn't want a vintage bag too much, with huge watermarks, or even worse, a huge soya sauce stain, to which I would have no personal connection at all. I guess that might not be really helpful for you. I'm sorry, because In the end, the decision is up to you. And I do not even have a strong recommendation. If you should go for the bag, and if so, new or pre-loved, just listen to your handbag heart, I guess. But what are your thoughts so far on the vintage second way? Do you own one, a vintage one? Or are you more into the neon way? Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you next time. And bye! Tragic. But I just not add to her character. Character. Add to character. And I 1933.